Hello everyone, welcome to yet another online session. I am Dr. Shruti Mohan, Assistant Professor from the Department of Samhita Siddhanta, Gokul Ayurveda College, Sidhpur. Today I am going to explain on the topic Dinacharya from Dinacharya Adhyaya Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthan. Before moving on to the subject proper, I would like to give a brief introduction. Ayurvedasya Prayojan is quoted as Prayojanam cha asya swastasya swasti rakshanam aturasya vikara prashamanam cha. It is mentioned in Charaka Samhita Sutrasthana 30th chapter, which means maintaining the health of a healthy and curing the disease of a rogi. So giving prime importance to the Prathama Prayojan, that is swastasya swasti rakshanam. Chapters such as Dinacharya, Riducharya, Roga Anutpadani Adhyaya, etc. are mentioned in Ashtanga Hridaya. Dinacharya Adhyaya or Dinacharya. Dine Dine Charya Dinacharya. Dinasya Charya Dinacharya. The regimens which we have to follow in a daily basis is considered as Dinacharya. So in today's presentation, I will be covering these topics, which includes Pradha Uddhana, Dantadhavana, Anjana, Tambula Sevana or Tambula Charvana, Abhyanga, Vyayama, Udvartanam and Snanam. Moving on to the first topic, that is Pradha Uddhana, waking up early in the morning. Brahme Muhurta Uttishtet Swastho Rekshartham Ayushaha Sharir Chindam Narvardya Krida Shauja Vidistataha. So, Swastho Rekshartham Ayushaha. What is Swastha? A person who is healthy. Swastho Anaduraha, who is devoid of any sort of diseases. In such a person or such a person, in order to protect his Ayu, in order to protect his life, should wake up during Brahma Muhurta. Brahma Muhurte Uttishteta. So what is Brahma Muhurta, for which our commentator of Ashtanga Hridaya, Arunadatta, commented that Ratri Chadurdasho Muhurto Brahma Muhurta. The 14th Muhurta of night is considered to be Brahma Muhurta. Out of the 15 Muhurtas of night, 14th Muhurta is considered as Brahma Muhurta. And also Brahma Jnanam. Tadartam adhyanadyabhi brahma tasya yogyo muhurta brahmaha. Brahma, jnanam, knowledge. So Brahma Muhurta is also considered to be the best time for attaining knowledge, that is adhyanadi, for studying. So this is regarding the importance of Pradha Uthana. Now moving on to the next topic, that is Dandadhavana, cleaning the teeth. Arka negrod kadir karanj kakumbadijam pradha buktva chamrudu agram kashaya kadu tiktakam kanini agra samastauliam pragunam dwadashangulam bakshaye danda bhavanam danda mamsani abadayan. So arka negrod kadir karanj kakumba, all these are plants or drugs which can be used for dandadhavana. So twigs of such plants which are having kashaya kadu tiktarasa should be used for dantadavana. Kanini agra samasthauliam pragunam dwadashangulam. These are the features of the twig which should be used for dantadavana. Here you can see the twigs. It should be kanini agra samasthauliam. Its width should be equal to the diameter of tip of small finger. Pragunam, without any bend, should be straight. Dwadashangulam, its measurements length should be 12 angula, that is nearly 9 inches. Then how should be the twigs? It should be mridu agram. The tip of the twig should be made soft by chewing. Pradha buktva cha eti dvikalam dandabhavanam bakshayed. So danda dhavana is recommended to be done in pradha kala and after having food. Danda mamsani abhadayan. Always make sure that while you do this, why you brush your teeth with the danta bhavana, it should not harm the danta mamsa or gums. So these are the drugs which are mentioned in shloka: arka, khadira, karancha, kakumba, etc. Now moving on to the contraindications for danta dhavana. Na adyad ajirna vama dushwasa kasa jwarardhiti trishna asya paga hrin netra shiraha karna amai chatat. Na adyad, it is contraindication. Dantadhavana is contraindicated to those who suffer from ajirna, indigestion, vamadu, vomiting, shwasa kasa, dyspnea, cough, jwara ardhiti, fever, facial palsy, trishna, thirst, asyapaka, that is mouth ulcerations, and amayas or diseases related to hridaya, netra, shira and karna. So such people who are afflicted by certain conditions should avoid dantadhavana. Now the next topic is anjana, that is collyrium application to eyes. Sauvira manjanam nityam hidam ashnohu tado bhajet. Sauvira anjana, a variety of collyrium or anjana preparation, it is nityam, it should be used in a daily basis because it is hita for eyes. Chakshuhu tejo mayam tasya vishesha adasleshmado bhayam yojayet saptaratre asmat sravanartam rasanjanam. Now the second variety or another variety of anjana, that is the rasanjana, about that it is said that chakshuhu tejo mayam, akshi is said to be teja mahabhuta predominant or agni mahabhuta predominant, but still sleshmato bhayam, that is it is always having the fear of getting afflicted by sleshma dosha or the kapha dosha, because the pradhana sthana of kapha is urdhvajatru, which includes akshi. So in order to eradicate or in order to secrete out the excess accumulated kapha dosha sravanartham, we can use rasanjana once in 7 days, saptaratre. So that is regarding rasanjana and sauviranjana. Tado navana gandusha dhuma tambula bhagabhaved. So after anjana we can follow navana, gandusha, dhuma, tambula, etc. Navana refers to nasya, that is nasal instillation. Gandusha or oil pulling, that is holding medicated liquid in orally for a certain period of time and then spitting it out. Dhumapana or inhaling medicated smoke. Tambula sevana or tambula charvana, that is chewing betel leaves. Now there are certain contraindications told for tambula sevana. Tambulam kshata pittasra ruksha utkupita chakshusha visha murcha madatanam apatyam shoshinamapi. So tambula sevana is contraindicated to those who suffer from kshata, pittasra, bleeding disorders, ruksha, dehydration, utkupita chakshusha, inflammatory condition of eyes, visha, vishabedita, murcha, giddiness, mada, intoxication, and shosha, emaciation. So such condition in the people who are afflicted by such conditions should avoid tambula sevana. Now moving on to the next topic, which is oil massaging or abhyanga. Abhyanga machare nityam, abhyanga should be done in a daily basis. Sa jarashrama vataha, then it will help in slowing down jara, aging. Shrama vataha, helps in eradicating exhaustion, and it is vadahara. Drishti prasada, helps in enhancing the vision drishti. Pushti, it will help in nourishment. Swapna, it will provide good sleep. Sutvak, it will give good skin. Dardyakrit, it will give a strong sharira or physique. Shirah Sravana Padeshu Tam Visheshena Shilayet. And particularly Abhyanga should be done in Shira, Sravana and Pada. One should not avoid these places while doing Abhyanga in a regular basis. Now there are contraindications for Abhyanga as well. Varjo Abhyanga. Abhyanga is contraindicated to those who suffer from Kafagrastha, who suffer from Kafaja Vyadis. Krita Samshuddhi. Ajirnivihi is one who have just undergone purificatory therapies and one who is suffering from indigestion related issues. Now the next topic is Vyayama, exercise. First itself, Vyayama labha or benefits of exercise is mentioned. Lakhavam karma samartyam dipto agnihi medasah kshayah vivakta ghana gatratvam vyayamat upajayate. So by regular practice of vyayama, one can achieve lakhavam, lekhuta to the sharira, lightness of the body. Karma samartyam, it provides energy to do work or efficiency to do work. Deepto Agni, it helps in increasing the digestive fire. Medha Sahakshayaha, it also helps in reducing excess medhas. Vibhakta Ghanakatratvam refers to a well-formed and strong body structure. So these are the labhas or the benefits of regular practice of Vyayama. Now, contraindication of Vyayama. Vada Pittamayi Balo Vriddho Achirno Chatam Tyajet. So, Vyayama should not be done by those who are affected with Vada Vikaras, Pitta Vikaras and also in Bala, Bala tender kids and Vriddha, Vriddha very aged people who are weak and also those who suffer from ajirna, indigestion related issues. Next is regarding Vyayama Matra, that is how much Vyayama we should do. Ardha Shaktiya Nishevastu Belibihi Snigdha Bhojibihi. Belibihi Snigdha Bhojibihi. A person who is Belavan and a person who is accustomed of taking Snigdha Bhojana regularly. Such a person can practice Vyayama in a regular basis, but Ardha Shaktiya, that is to half of his capacity or half of his strength. So how can we analyze Ardha Shakti, for which Ashtanga Sangraha Sutra Sthana quotes Swedagamana Kakshi Lalat Nas Hasta Pada Sandhi. So Swedagamana, in all these parts by which we can analyze Ardha Shakti. Shita Kale Vasandecha Mandameva Tado Anyata. In Shita Kala and in Vasanda Ritu, one healthy person can practice Vyayama to Ardha Shakti. Mandameva Tado Anyata. But in all other ritus, Vyayama should be done manda, that is mildly. Now, after Vyayama, what we should do? Tam kritva anusukham deham mardayecha samandataha. After doing Vyayama, one should do mardana, that is soft massage to all over the sharira comfortably. These are the lakshanas of adi vyayama. Excess vyayama will lead to trishna, kshaya, pratamako, rekta pittam, shramaha, tyamaha. Adi vyayama dhakaso, jvara chardischa jayate. So trishna, that is excess thirst, kshaya, that's emaciation, pratamako, dyspnea, rekta pittam, bleeding disorders, shramaha klamaha, fatigueness of sharira as well as manas, adivyayama dahaka so jwara chardi, and also adivyayama can lead to kaf, jwara, fever and chardi. व्यायाम जागर अथवा स्त्री हास्य भाष्यादि साहसम गजम सिंहम इवाकर्षन भजन्नति विनशयति. सो अति मात्र सेवना ऑफ ऑल दिस एक्टिविटीज नॉट ओनली व्यायाम बट रात्रि जागरण अथवा एक्सेस वॉकिंग एक्सेस सेक्सुअल एक्टिविटीज excess hasya, laughing, excess of talking, all such sahasas, if done in excess, will definitely harm the sharira. For which one simile is given, gajam simham ivakarshan bhajannati vinashayati. Just like a lion who attacks an elephant will harm his own sharira. Similarly, the adimatra sevana of all these activities will harm our sharira. Now, moving on to the next topic, that is udvarthanam. Udvarthanam or body massaging with powder. Udvarthanam kafaharam medasaha pravilayanam sthirikaranam anganam tvak prasadakaram param. So, udvarthana will help in kafaharanam, medasaha pravilayanam, that is, it will help in reducing medas, excess medas, sthidhikaranam anganam, it helps in providing firmness to the sharira, tvak prasadakaram param, and also it clarifies the skin. So these are the benefits of udvarthan or powder massage. Now moving on to the last topic, that is snanam. Deepanam vrishyamayushyam snanam urjabalapradam kandu mala shrama sveda tandra tridaha pavmajit. So regular practice of snana or bathing will help in deepana, that is increases the digestive power. Vrishyam enhances virility. Ayushyam longevity. Snanam urjabalapradam, it gives bala, strength to the sharira as well as enthusiasm, and also one can tackle all these features like kandu, itching, mala, dirt, shrama, fatigueness, sveda, tandra, trid, daha, burning sensation, all such things can be tackled by proper snana, even papa karmas. उष्णाम्बुना अधः कायस्य परिशेको बलावः तेनैव तु उत्तमांगस्य बलहृत् केशचक्षुषा. सो ऑलवेज उष्णाम्बु और वार्म वाटर इज सजेस्टेड फॉर अधः काय परिशेगा, फॉर यूजिंग इन अधः काय, दैट इज बिलो द नेक रीजन. इट विल प्रोवाइड स्ट्रेंथ और बला टू द शरीर. But the same Ushna Ambu, if used in Uttamanga, that is head, then it will do Belahrit Kesha Chakshusha. It will result in Belahrit, of it will affect badly hair as well as Chakshu or eyes. So always Ushna Ambu is recommended for Adhakaya Parishega only, not for Uttamanga. Now, moving on to the contraindications of snana. Who should not take bath? Snanam ardhita netra asya karna roga adhisarishu atmana penasa ajirna bukta vastucha garhitam. So, snana is contraindicated to those who suffer from ardhita facial palsy, netra asya karna rogas, rogas related to netra asya and karna, atisara, who is suffering from diarrhea, atmana, who is suffering from blotting, penasa, rhinitis, ajirna, that is one who is suffering from indigestion related issues, and buktavastu. Buktavastu refers to a person who have immediately taken food. So in such avasthas, snana is contraindicated. So that is regarding the topic snana. So I hope the class was enjoyable. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.